Hey. Hey, detective? What are you doing?
I found something.
Great. Was it alcohol?
God, no. I just got the wind knocked out of me. I think I know how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
What exactly does that mean?
Everything going back to normal.
All right. I found some more information on Dorsetto and the patients. There are some seriously strange things going on here. I'm pretty sure two of the patients are dead, and maybe even the clerk.
Oh, yeah. I kind of just gave up on worrying about that.
Well, just keep your eyes open, I suppose. What were you doing again?
Jeremy made a pact with the Dark Man to keep all the madness locked inside Dorsetto.
All right.
I'm gonna break it. I just have to... Where is it? Where's the talisman?
It's around your neck. I worry, Detective.
Don't, I'm fine.
I worry that you're not much help on this case. At least you're a good distraction.
Trust me, you're getting your money's worth. At this rate, I'm an absolute bargain.
To be around here somewhere. He wouldn't leave this house.
I don't know what to think anymore. You run into that detective fella?
Who is he? Can he be trusted?
I think he wanted a good guy. Well, you know, like us.
Will he be all right with her coming? Praise the mother.
He don't need to know about all that. Just calm down. Ain't time yet.
God. Hurts.
As far as I can tell, Detective Combi seems to be solving problems, not causing.
Just be ready in case he starts anything.
The two orderly.
Was that? I don't want to run into the orderlies right now. Not sure I can trust them. I think Dr. Gray might be in there. Perfect time to snoop around his office, though. It's blocked.
Detective Convey. Good to see you again. Solved your case yet?
I'm trying. Hey, Grace, you okay?
Oh, she is just peachy, Detective. Are you looking forward to the Feast of St. John, Grace?
I can't wait.
Kids, ain't they great?
What exactly are you planning for tonight?
Oh, not much. We eat, we drink, we pay tribute to the wishing tree in the conservatory. The usual.
Then why all the excitement?
There is just something about tonight. Something's different. I think we all feel it. Besides, we got ourselves some new words for the prayer, thanks to your buddy Jeremy.
She'll come and turn the world inside out, and things will begin again.
That sounds strangely threatening.
You should come.
Oh, God damn it, Grace. Stay put for once.
Better hold on to these. Wouldn't want them to get lost.
I can't leave. I got a job to do.
There must be a spare key to Dr. Gray's office in here somewhere. I don't have the combination for this. Or maybe Jeremy did. It worked.
The last guest in the empty room suffered from severe maladaption. I must write this down, because if I understand the condition...
Dr. Gray's office, all to myself. Let's see if we can figure this guy out.
This is where McCarthy has hidden my favorite yacht.
I have finished tidying.
This is my room.
I belong. I recognize this view. I know the combination. I carry it with me.
Detective, I have made many discoveries in my case. The child we want is safe, thanks to good people like me and you. We're so...
How long have I been here?
Take this much more. This has to end.
Hypothetical psychosurgery, radiography.
Mind if I do?
That's better.
Why does this keep happening? What am I supposed to do?
Thank you.
And we're back here. Well, perfect time to have a look around this place.
Is anyone there?
Jeremy?
I need help!
Wait. Can you hear me?
I'm stuck in the mud and the fire is taking
Jeremy,
me.
Where are you?
The motor is dead. I can't do anything more.
Hang on, Jeremy. I'll figure something out. I'll get the boat running.
Boat's wedged itself right into the bayou. If I get the motor started, I could try reversing back into the river.
Jeremy, where are you?
pretty weak. I just... This definitely needs fuel.
Years ago, Frederic needed me to die.
You're not making any sense, Jeremy. Come back. Find your focus.
Hey!
I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part.
Hey!
I escaped my doom.
My destiny.
Again, find your focus.
Hey, I'm right here. What the hell is going on?
Now everything is wrong. Nothing is in place.
I'm right here!
Calm down, Mr. Conby. What do you want?
Were you not talking to Jeremy right now?
I haven't seen Jeremy all day. Are you all right, Detective?
No. Actually, I don't think so. Well, maybe. I'm gonna go look for Jeremy.
Good. Let me know if you find him.
I think Dr. Gray might be in there. Perfect time to snoop around his office, then.
Brother, I need you to trust me.
Detective Conby.
There's something missing.
Jeremy knew that the
Dearest Dr. Manzel. Jeremy was calling out for help, but Combi couldn't figure out where the voice was coming from. For a moment, Combi wondered if the boat itself was Jeremy, or if he was below it somehow. It didn't matter right now. Jeremy was clear on one thing. He wanted Combi to get the steamboat running and out of the mud.
Surprisingly neat. Maybe I've been selling that old barfly short.
Sometimes.
Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside. Why would McCarthy lock this up?
Was he trying to keep Grace from completing the shape? If so, couldn't she have just made another drawing?
What the hell happened in here?
This looks familiar. How am I back at the office? That's me, isn't it? How long? Been since I drowned myself in drink and depression. It had all felt so peaceful, slipping away into oblivion. A welcoming dark voice wrapped around my mind like a heavy blanket. It turned off suddenly as I woke up from the sound of my office door closing shut. A messenger had left a telegram. Mrs. Saunders. She had a lead on where to find her husband and her kidnapped daughter. I used to drink so much back then. When was this exactly? What case was I working? I remember this case. Some kid got taken by her father, headed out of state. But he had made a mistake by selling a painting that his wife actually cared about to a collector named Thornhill to fund his venture. That's how I tracked him down. At least I think so. Case can't be squeaky clean. Mr. Saunders had sold a valuable painting to Thornhill, hoping the money would carry him to wherever he was going. The painting, now leaning on an easel in Thornhill's bedroom, had a certain mesmerizing gloom that seemed to call out to me, telling me I was needed for something important. I felt myself falling into the painting, only being brought back by Thornhill, thrusting an address to a Hotel St. George into my hand, and asking me to get the hell out. I don't remember this at all, but I can't say it didn't happen. On my way to the hotel, the Morton gang caught up with me. I owed them money, a lot of it. I can't remember what for, probably some dumb gambling debt growing in size for each payment missed. I punched one of them out, and I sent the others packing. It was a
a stupid move. They'd be back.
I found him. In the hotel ledger, I recognized the handwriting of the signature, Ted Stryker. It was him. I could feel it. It was the kidnapper I was hunting. I put on my knuckles and hurried up to his room.
Something about that name, Ted Stryker, rings a bell. Feels vaguely familiar. This room, but I didn't catch up with them here. I must have followed them, but where? That's right, he was running away, ditching his old life and marriage in New Orleans to find something better in Tallahassee. And he took his daughter with him against the will of the mother. That's why she hired me. But I stopped him. I caught up with him at the Pearl River Bridge. Pearl River. This is where I caught up with him. This is what the dark man wanted me to revisit. And I'm still not seeing it. What am I forgetting? I can't believe I didn't recognize him.
I looked a little different back then, I suppose.
Was any of this real?
How do you mean?
This day, just... so much is happening. I can't... I think I've lost my head. Do you need me to apologize? I mean, I am sorry. I don't think I can even begin to explain. You're just a kid, Grace. I'm really sorry. I didn't mean for it to happen.
Lies. More lies.
No, really. I thought I was being a good guy by handing you over to your mother. I didn't know. I couldn't have known that she wouldn't care about you.
I don't know how this works. What is this for?
Some form of admission of guilt. Maybe acceptance. It's what the Dark Man wants.
I guess we just watch my father die again, then.
You think he's alive?
I know he is. He's down there, scared that he won't be able to get out. That he will drown with his daughter again.
What are you saying? We gotta save him!
We? Do it yourself. I'm down there with him, remember?
Can I really save them? This all happened so long ago. I have to find a way to get down there. I have to see it with my own eyes. There was a boat at the house where I entered. If I can raise the bridge, I should be able to get to the car. This must be where the bridge is operated. Nothing's happening. It's like something's holding it back.
My God, Carnby. Are you okay?
Don't leave me alone.
What the hell have you been doing?
What's going on here? Look at this mess!
I'm sorry, Mrs. Thompson.
Don't make me kick you out of this house! Now get out!
Hey, Detective. Mr. Carnby. I'm really worried about you.
I'm okay. I just need to catch my breath for a moment.
This place? It's... There are some very disturbed figures around here. And I don't think it's just the patients. I've been reading some things about how Dorsetto has a deranging effect on people. I think it might explain... things.
What?
Just take it easy, okay? I'm gonna go find a way into Dr. Gray's apartment. I wanna know what he's hiding.
Emily? Don't worry. I think I'm close. I'm gonna set everything right.
Just be careful.
Carnby had run.
Detective, am I glad to see you. Lock the door, will you? I don't think Dr. Gray would appreciate us snooping around.
What's going on here? This feels so strange. There's a book missing.
What did you do?
I was just rearranging the books.
Well, come on, let's check it out. I think I'm beginning to understand. Dr. Gray is dealing with some kind of mass delusion.
That mark on the floor looks like talisman positions, but from which direction should I look at it?
This...
Good to... Has that been there this whole time? Hello?
Detective Carnby?
Who is this? Jeremy?
Jeremy is with the Dark Man. You can't save him.
Well, I've done everything he wanted so far, and there's just one more thing on the list. I expect him to keep his promise and return Jeremy unharmed.
Get out, detective, while you still can.
You okay? You look a little frazzled.
Just stupid telephone.
I know. I tried calling the police earlier. The telephone is completely dead.
It's not... Yeah, no, the telephone isn't working. Miss Hartwood, I think you're gonna want to see this.
Is there something in the closet?
Yeah, there is. You don't see the very obvious gate leading to whatever Jeremy's madness is serving up next?
I don't understand. Are you making some kind of fashion metaphor? I'm sorry, I don't have time for this. Can you just tell me what you're doing?
You don't see this! It's fine. It's fine. Catch you later.
Are you going inside the closet?
Yeah. You got a problem with that?
No. Do what you think is right, Detective.
Sorry, I didn't mean to. Goodbye, Miss Hartwood.
Found the ancient...
Hey, you! What are you doing here? What is this place?
Turn back, detective. You're not wanted here.
Whoa, take it easy. I'm not your enemy.
Oh, you're wrong, detective. You're wrong.
Stars aligned, Jeremy, or maybe that is what you need to temper that mania of yours.
From me! You want me to lose my mind?
Oh, my love!